If you haven't heard of Afrochickulture before now, you are definitely tuned into the right show. This catchphrase, which is used by the creator of Nigerian fashion brand BlingShiki, say it represents an interesting fusion between unconventional fashion, which is hippie and futuristic, yet still grounded in African heritage. I know, it's a mouthful, but don't worry, we unpack all of that and so much more right now on this episode. My name is Sika Osei, and welcome to Fashion Insider. Tolu, welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome, Sika. Welcome to Fashion Insider.
Thank you, Sika. How are you today?
I'm great. I am so great. So, Tolu, I'm going down your website and I see that you've given us a challenge, a little tongue twisting challenge. So I'm going to take you up on your challenge. What am I supposed to say 10 times?
BlingShiki.
Okay. Are you ready?
Okay.
Because I think I'm going to be very good at this. Okay. Okay. BlingShiki, 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 BlingShiki. I got it right. I was like, no, I can definitely do that. I
can
definitely do that.
I can't do it.
You can?
No.
No, it's okay. We're not going to put you through that.
Thank you.
Let's start off by telling us, how has it been? Has it been all that you wanted it to be? Tell us about the journey so far.
It wasn't as though I really loved Bling when I started. No, I was doing I used to customize t-shirts, or I still do customize t-shirts, like print, you know, logos and, you know, people's names and stuff on t-shirts.
I think you did something with Gideon.
Yes.
Yes,
remember,
I saw that.
Yeah.
Yes, I remember that.
And then I had a t-shirt party at some point in time, and I had people wear the t-shirts, whatever you want, just buy the t-shirts from me.
Mm.
So it was more like business and party. And then after a while, people would say, okay, now I want that thing. Can you write it with stones?
Okay.
Can you do this? And I said, okay. And at the time, I'd just gotten the UN money.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, I think I need to invest in some crystals. And I realized that not so many people were doing them here. And those who did them here would sort of import the motifs and apply. So it was pretty much, it wasn't for me. It wasn't, you know, creativity.
Gotcha.
So I had to, I mean, with my curl draw background, find a way or understand how they did it over there.
Mm-hmm.
So in America, you guys create the thing. How do you do it? In China, you do this. How do you do it?
Okay.
So I understood the process, got the machines, and then I started customizing t-shirts with rhinestone embellishments.
Okay.
And then my mom does ashoke. So I started doing the rhinestones on her ashoke. And then I started doing ashoke.
Mm.
And then one day I asked myself, so what is the future? People are now bringing in this thing from China to make the ashoke rhinestones. T-shirts, the money, maybe not where I want to be at. And then, so what are you really known for, Tolu? And I thought to myself, maybe I should start this BlingShiki with stones instead of embroidery on them.
Mm.
And that was how I went home, thought this through, and then I created the first piece, which is the classic collection.
Which is the one behind there.
So it took actually 2 months. It wasn't that easy.
Yeah.
So I created that piece and then people were like, yeah, yeah.
So once you created that piece, you knew it's an aesthetic that was going to work.
And then someone said, so what do we call this? Mm. What do we call them? Like, okay, BlingShiki, no. BlingShiki, yes! You know, and that was it. So it wasn't as though I went through any, no.
Okay. No. It was just that moment of inspiration.
Yes,
so you say your designs are futuristic. They're hippie.
Mm-hmm.
There's like a new pop culture that you're trying to create.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Okay. So can you wear like Iran Buba in the London Underground?
Well, I mean, conventionally, I probably wouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
I would wear something more comfortable, maybe jeans and a t-shirt.
Yeah.
But if it was cool enough, I may actually wear it.
So that's where we're going. I want to make African fashion cool enough for you to wear over there. And they say, what are you wearing? Is that from Africa? And then like, yeah.
I like your British accent.
Very funny.
Yeah. So there, it basically catches their eye and it's something very different.
Mm-hmm.
So now you created this whole new aesthetic for yourself.
Yeah.
So, okay, moving on, we have this dashiki and stuff like that, but I noticed that it's very unisex.
Yes.
It's something men can wear, women can wear, and I know you have kids and babies,
yes,
and now you're designing for them as well.
Yes.
crazy. Mm-hmm. How is that whole, you know, dynamic worked out for you?
Okay, so first problem that I had when I started this business of fashion is fitting. Oh, it doesn't fit here. It doesn't. And so I wanted something that people would just wear, throw on, and then I'm like, boom.
Yes.
So I had to find a piece that's easy to wear, one size fits all-ish, you know, and also unisex.
How did the men take it? Because I don't know a lot of men who would be very comfortable throwing on rhinestones. They'll be like, no, this is a woman's thing.
Yeah.
But how did they take it? And how were you able to, you know, coerce them into, like, also getting on board with that?
Okay, so celebrities.
Oh, okay.
So I can
the power of
tell
celebrity.
You that most people want to dress up like maybe a Daria Taladi or a Adekunle Gold or a Fowls or something. You know, that thing Fowls was wearing, that same color. How I wanted it.
So that was your marketing strategy.
Yes, that was it, really. So I had to, you know, find all these men, boys, guys, help my industry, help me now. And you know, I can't just, you know, come into this market and people will just buy from. They must see you guys wear it. And when you wear it, they know that, okay, the product really exists. It's not something that I've just found somewhere on the internet and put on my Instagram page. They need to know that this product really exists.
Yeah.
So I got these guys, you know, they wore these things and people start to see that, okay, it's for real. And then for the older people, they don't like bling. They're like, how would I wear blings? It looks nice, so dashiki. But how? So we say, okay, so I will make you white with clear crystals. So it sort of blends in.
So the light just catches it at the right
moment. Absolutely. And so it looks really, you know, regal and it looks very elegant and easy. Blue with blue crystals, it looks good, cool. It's not all that in your face. I'm not a celebrity. I can't be wearing clothes like Michael Jackson. Don't worry, we have something for you.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, everyone starts to say, okay, it's fine, I would wear it. Oh, let me see. Miles, I might not like it, but let me try. Miles, I really liked it too. Hey, Tolu, thank you very much. He wants another one. And that's how
it starts. Yeah. How many years has it been since you started this business?
3 years.
BlingShiki
is 3 years. So I've had other businesses. I have a business done 11 years. I have 10 years.
Okay. What businesses are those?
So I started with printing.
Mm-hmm.
So I have Paw Print Limited. That's been for 10 years. We print like annual reports, calendars, brochures and stuff like that.
Wow.
Souvenirs and stuff.
So do you still do that?
Yes, I still do that.
Okay.
I mean, that's on the side.
Okay.
Then I have, Addict by Paw Print. That's the t-shirt line.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's also there.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have Ashwara. That's the Ashoke business.
Okay. And that's also you do with
there.
Your mom.
Yes.
Okay.
That's also there.
Yes.
And then I have BlingShiki.
Yes.
That's also there. And then I have a new baby.
I was just about to say, she does all of this. She's a wife. She's a mother. How do you even get time? It's insane. And you're just one person.
Yeah.
Is it true that at some point you decided you didn't want to get a nanny. You didn't want to get a driver.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted to do this all by yourself.
Yeah. Do you know that getting a nanny actually is extra work? Because you have to watch her. Did you clean the diaper? Ma, I did. Oh, you have to look. But that thing is still there. Clean that thing. Might as well just do it yourself.
So what? But so you bring baby to work?
Yeah.
And you just put her on your back?
Yeah, she has her own little corner over there. If you see her as a lifestyle, it becomes easy.
Okay.
It's not work.
Mm.
When I have work to do, I can't do it, and I have to take practice of my baby.
Mm.
I take her as priority. I look after her, and I put the work aside.
Mm.
And guess what? At the end of the day, the work still gets done.
Mm.
So I mean, because I can't have my emotions here and there. Because I mean, she's a baby, and I still have to look after her.
So Tolu, in a situation like yours, because I know a lot of mothers and wives are watching who are trying to just, you know, do that balancing act. How important is it to have trusted people that you can allocate work to that you know that the work is going to be done?
Okay, so in my business, I have, say, around 2 or 3 people that I know can do everything.
Okay.
So no one gets a Grammy for knowing everything or doing everything.
Yeah.
So I make sure that I do less of the work. When I started, it was just me doing everything.
Yeah.
As I grew, I learned to delegate
and
teach them also the process.
So you're very good in customization, as I can see. Are we seeing that you're going to maybe move from clothes to maybe technology, maybe even just customize anything from shoes to microphones to headphones? I mean, are we going in that direction also?
Okay. So you're asking for my future plan.
Yes.
My long-term plan is interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I have a baby line coming soon.
Okay.
I have a pencil factory that I just started with my husband. So we're going to, we have started customizing pencils for schools.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll make them from recycled paper. Yes. So I have accessory line coming soon as well. Mm-hmm. BlingShiki. I want to see, really, this is the idea.
You just want to take over the world.
No,
simple.
No, just buy an item, 1,000 naira from me.
Yeah.
And 1 million people buy it. So I'm trying to come down, I mean,
with the prices.
Yes.
So really
that everybody's happy. So that number is important.
It's very, very important.
Very important, yeah.
Wow. I'm in awe. Here I was thinking I was just going to come talk about BlingShiki,
you know,
and you told me so much. Like,
thank
you. You're really trying to take over the world. And in doing that, you've done African Fashion Week in London,
yes,
and so much more. Mm-hmm. How has that experience been like? Has it added to your growth?
Yes. So I'd say that, I mean, to say the celebrities alone helped the brand would not be fair.
Mm.
The exhibitions, the fashion shows have been very, very key to this growth.
Mm.
You know, these people give us so much exposure. People come and see what you're doing and they like the presentation.
Yeah.
They like the quality of what you're giving them. And then that's how they spread the word.
Yeah. You know? Do you think this is a profitable business to be in?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Pays the bills.
It has.
Never owed a staff salary.
Wow.
Never.
So have you made back all the investments that you put back in this business?
Have I made back is interesting because I keep putting the money back in. I plug it back in.
Okay.
What I do is I pay myself a salary that's, you know, that I'm comfortable taking, not peanuts.
Yes.
Something that I know that when I go with, I don't have to dip into the company's money.
Okay.
And then I know that there's still room for expansion. We've been 3 years now. They say 5 years is when you can say that the business is going to survive.
Mm-hmm.
So BlingShiki is only 3 years. 2 years time, I'll say, okay, now we're good to go. So, yeah, it's profitable, but the money keeps going back in there. We need to, you know, ensure that it's something that would stay.
Got you.
Yeah. So I'm not looking at the money.
Yes. And soon you're going to be in Milan.
Yeah.
In the UK.
Yeah.
All over
Fashion
Europe.
Week, yeah.
Just doing big things and just blinging all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
Well
That's
done.
The idea. Thank
well
you.
Done. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you, Sika.
So great meeting you. I've learned so much and I'm so inspired.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you for coming as well.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.
Well, boundless inspiration after speaking to Tolu of BlingShiki. I mean, I'm always inspired after I do an interview. But what I've learned today is to not sell yourself short. Expand, explore, and just be great at everything you do. And a little rhinestone never hurt nobody. If you've enjoyed this and so much more, make sure to go on our social media pages. I've been Sika Osei, and this has been Fashion Insider. See you next week.